ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो। महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय यं प्राव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतोष तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमां शरणं। I wanted to explain almost all the pastimes, sweet pastimes of Krishna. Especially I wanted to explain the glories of gopis. But I was involved in only Bal Leela Charitra.
Childhood pastimes.
Only in this, so I could not go up. No? I wanted. So, I want to tell some brief things. After Yashoda Maiya binded Krishna, he became Damodar. But Damodar of Srimati Maiya Yashoda. And after that, in Ras Leela, he became Radha Damodar. All the Sakhi binded Krishna with Srimati Radhika. Then he became Radha Damodar. So after these pastimes of Yashoda Damodar, this pastimes was when Krishna was at the age of 3.5 only. Seeing this, that so many troubles are coming, so many demons are here. They try to kill Krishna, but by the mercy of Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is Narayan, or by the mercy of Giriraj Govardhan, Krishna is shaped. Kansa also thought that I've sent so many demons, my friends, to kill Krishna, but he could not do. They could not. Anyone to whom I sent to Braja to kill Krishna, they never returned. Never returned. What happened? So he wanted to go himself there, and himself he wanted to kill Krishna. So he made a plan. He ride on a horse and took his swords. He was so powerful, more than Putana, Agasur, Bakasur and all. He crossed Jamuna River and he has a very beautiful garden there, crossing river Jamuna. And when he reached, and he wanted to cross the borderline of Mathura and entering in
Gokul.
Gokul. At once he saw a very old lady, hairs all white, and his dress was somewhat saffron colors. Her name was Jogmaya, Purnima. He asked and challenged Kans. Kans, where are you going? Where you are going? Stop. And at once he was stopped. He was so powerful, but he could not disobey the order of Jogmaya. Though she was so old, he knew that he is going to kill Krishna. At once, forcibly, he took the hands of Kans and he, in a pond,
drowned him.
Dipped him down into the pond.
Dunked.
And again,
came out.
Took out. And at once he felt, oh, I am a very old lady. Crooked, black, no teeth,
ugly,
so ugly, and no power to also
walk.
Jogmaya gave him one stick and told him, you should be here. And you should, from today, we will do cow dungs. Town dungs, man?
From cow dung to cow patty. Good.
And he used to be here. And she kicked from his feet or legs. And he went into Braj. And he told that, see how old, ugly, a lady has come from Mathura and I have engaged. And go and see, and if she is not good working, then you should kick her. So all became, they assembled there. And one by one, kicking her, that lady. He wanted to run away from that place. But how to go? He wanted to return to his kingdom, Mathura. But he thought that if I am returning there, that anyone will not recognize that I am same Kans. And there also they will kick me. So what to do? So some days he was like this, feeling so much unhappy and ashamed. Then he began to pray, oh Jogmaya, you should come and be very merciful to me. I will never in future come and try to kill him, Krishna. At once Jogmaya came and again he drowned in that pond and quickly took off, and then he became Kans, and quickly
with his feet in his
he ran away to his kingdom. So he never came in future to Braja to do any harm to Krishna. But he was sending. After this, all the Brajavasis thought that so many disturbances are coming here. Problems are coming. And there now no grass for cows to graze. So we should give up this place and we should go to any better place where there are grasses and our cows can graze. And this will be a very best place. And they selected Vrindavan. And then they come. Here Krishna began to graze little calves, and one day he was grazing. At once a bakasur means a demon in shape of crane. And Krishna, he wanted to take Krishna in his stomach, but Krishna became like a gola. What?
Ball.
Ball.
Like an iron ball, so burning.
Like javelin.
And reddish. At once he
spit out
disc.
And then he began to like this. But Krishna quickly took his two
beaks.
One from
legs.
And other like doing anvil. But in two pieces. Krishna, that I was playing with you, you are also playing with. But if you are dying, what should I do? Nothing to do. But he gave him liberation. Anyhow. After that, Aghasur sent any demon named Aghasur. Aghasur means, Agh means pap.
Sin.
Sinful.
So many sins like. Like, if I have murdered Gurudev, father, mother, like these sins, he was embodiment of all kinds of sin in this world. He came to kill Krishna, but he could not do. He swallowed all the cowherd boys and cops, everyone. But he was waiting for Krishna. Krishna quickly came, and he went also inside. And when Krishna came inside, he at once
closed
his mouth. But again, Krishna came here. No air here and to pass. Everything was blocked. His eyes also came out. And at once, this was cracked. And his soul came out, and wandering in the sky. But when Krishna, by his sight, like nectar, he saw all the cowherd boy and calves, at once in life, all they came out of his mouth. And then the light which was in the sky gradually came and entered in the Lord's feet of Krishna. Brahma was looking this. Oh, very big sannyasis and yogi, doing so much hard austerities, it is very rare that they have the same
destination.
Destination. But how he quickly achieved so high class of liberation. He wanted to see some more pastimes of his Prabhu. And he wanted to stroll away the cowherd boys and cops and to see another, what he does. And he quickly arranged. What happened in the meantime? That all the mothers of Braja, all the mothers of whole Braja, they used to love Krishna more than their sons. And thinking that Krishna should be our son, so that we can take Krishna in our laps and always giving milk, always supporting and nursing Krishna, loving with so affection, they wanted. Also, all the now girls of Braja, they have become like 7, 8, they have some intelligence also. So they wanted that, oh, Krishna should be our beloved, our husband. All the cows in Braj, lakhs and crores of cows, they wanted to love Krishna like their children's calves. So what happened? Jogmaya at once dragged Brahma, and she showed Krishna these pastimes of Aghasur murder, killing. So actually, Jogmaya inspired Brahma to stall away the cowherd boys and calves. When they were taking prasadam anywhere, in Bhandirban, in Bhandirbat, in the place, and they were playing themselves. Krishna sat in the middle, and lakhs of cowherd boys surrounding Krishna were sitting there. One round, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, thousands of surrounding was there. But all who were back of Krishna, they are thinking that we are in front of Krishna. Those who were very far away, they were thinking that Krishna, I am with Krishna.
Nearer to Krishna.
And they are giving something to him, he taking something. In the meantime, cows were some far different. Grazing, they become of some distance. So Brahma had a chance to tuck away and stole away. Also, when Krishna and our brother, the cowherd boy, were searching their cows, their calves, in the meantime, Brahma took away all the cowherd boys and kept in a
cave.
Krishna was thinking that where my calves has gone, where my friends are there. At once he knew, oh, what happened? And then he became all the cowherd boy. He became all the
calves.
And he became all the bansuri,
flutes
of all goats.
Flutes, sticks, dresses.
Sticks, their kambalia. Kambalia, you know?
Dresses.
Blanket.
Kambal.
Blankets.
And everything Krishna became. The cowherd boys, their voices, tone of speaking, their mood of walking,
all behavior.
Everything became like this. And Krishna used to take them and daily going to their homes and coming again in grazing and doing. He did like
one year.
And in this period, Gargacharya told that this year is so
auspicious.
If anyone be married to in this year, they'll be happy forever. Anyone will not be widow, and the boys will be also so happy. So you should try to marry. If anyone has any child in their homes, they should also be married anyhow. How can be married? Oh, they promised to each other, father and mother, that if there will be a son and my will be daughter, then we will marry. Or if you have daughter, I have son, then we should also marry. Like this. So all the girls were married. To whom they are married? Because Krishna was himself cowherd boy. So all marriage was done to
Krishna.
So all the gopis are the wives of Krishna. But in that shape, not in Krishna shape, but in shape of
cowherd boys.
Cowherd. Anyhow, it be. Achinta ghat pati yasi.
Ghatana pati yasi.
Anyhow, they will do.
Infancy.
Jogma is so expert and so powerful. So, Krishna became the son of all the gopis. And Krishna became the calf of all the cows. And he became husband of all the gopis. And the purple was sharped. After a year, when Brahma returned, he was in confusion that Krishna is playing even with his cops and cowherd boy. But I have kept there. I should go and see. And he went and saw that, oh, all are there, sleeping. And when he looked here, he saw that Krishna is playing with all. So Krishna is so perhaps powerful, both time. When I'm going to there, to them, and Krishna is taking all the boils and coughs here, and when I'm going there, he takes them here. But for four eyes here and four eyes here, when he saw that, oh, in both places, how it began? Then he surrendered himself in the lotus feet of Krishna. He saw that everywhere, 400 Narayan was there, everywhere. And then he thought, oh, he is my worshipful deity, Brahma. He is my Aradhadev. And then he fell flat. And when he saw towards Krishna, he saw that again Krishna taking
rice
in his hand and
yogurt.
And
searching.
With floating and searching again. Where my cowherd boy has gone? My friend has gone. Where my cups has gone? Like this. Brahma knew that, oh, he is Ishwar of Ishwar.
God of
Ishwara
God.
Sarva Krishna. Ishwara Parama Krishna Sachidananda. Sarva Karana Karana. He realized that he is even more than Narayan. Narayan is part and some part of manifestation of Krishna. Krishna is Swayam Supreme Personality. And all are some, what?
Expansion.
Incarnations.
Expansion.
Expansions of Krishna. Then he realized it through. And he prays that, I want to be a dust in Vrindavan, or even a stone in Vrindavan, where those who are called Jamadarni in India,
sweepers.
Even after their job, when they will return to their home, I will be a stone piece there, and with water they will wash their feet on
that stone.
I want to be even a that stone. I am not so lucky to be anything in Vrindavan, even a grass. But I want the mercy of all the gopis. Anywhere I want to take a birth, so that I should be a sprinkled mercy of devotees, true devotees. So much he has prayed. After this, Krishna and Baldev went to Madhuvan to graze cows, and after that they came to Madhuvan or
Talvan,
where the trees of
palm
tree was there so much, lakhs and lakhs. All the boys wanted to take some juice of palm fruit, because at that time they were ripen. So very beautiful smell was coming, very
sweet fragrance.
Baldev went there and he took a tree in his hand and he did like this, and so many fruits came. At once the donkeys came and they attacked Krishna and Baldev and all the boys' friends, but quickly they were all killed by Krishna and Baladev. So, who are donkey? Those who try to serve a king like Kans, their friends all are donkey, those who have no relation with Krishna and not serving Krishna. So those who are not really devotees of Krishna, they are like donkeys. They have no intelligence to see that how we can be happy forever. So all are donkey. They want to taste this worldly desires, sense gratifications. All are like demon, like this donkey. So Gurudev Baldev Prabhu is wholesale guru, and he killed that donkey. After that, they controlled Kaliya. They controlled Pralambasu, they killed Pralambasu. And so many things they did. Indra was also controlled. He has a false ego that I am creator of this world, I am supporter of this world. So Krishna wanted to
teach him a lesson.
Teach a good lesson. So he told all the Brijabasi, don't worship Indra. Indra is not a supreme personality. He cannot do anything. He is like a servant of Krishna. But he has a false ego. You should worship Giriraj Govardhan. He can fulfill everything. He is Govardhan. By serving Giriraj Govardhan or cows, gopi, gopas, every will be so happy. Nanda Baba do so, and after Indra became so angry, and he wanted to punish all the gopis and Krishna also, but he was punished. I have told all these things yesterday. So, it shows that any demigoddesses, even Brahma, Shankar, Mahesh and all, but to speak of Durga, Kali, Ganesh, Shankar or any, they are not supreme personality of Godhead. Even not Godhead, only their God and gods, only the servants of Krishna. Not even to Krishna, to Khirodasai Vishnu or Garbhodasai like that. They are like God in this world, like Chaukidar.
Watchman.
Having no power at all. But we should try to respect them, not thinking that they are like God. In India, so many persons, they think that Ganesh, Shankar, Hanuman, Kali, Durga, and all the goddesses are same, like Krishna. No difference between Krishna and them. But this is wrong thing. We should not try to do. Otherwise, it will be a very big offense. We should try to know that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ne? And without His mercy, anything, anyone cannot do. So we should try to worship Him, to chant and remember. Best is the thing that chant always, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
But you should try to give honor even to a grass. Because Krishna is there in every autumn seas, so we will, but not considering Him that He is God. We are not God. We are not Brahman or Brahma. After that, Ras was done, Ras Leela. Very beautiful. For one day of Brahma, lakhs years, continuing going, but everyone thought that, oh, this is only 12
hours
night, very quickly passed. After that, consent Akrur, you should go to Braja, and at that time Krishna was in Nandagaon. Go, and anyhow, by crook or you should bring Krishna and Baldev. And here when we'll come, we all friends, like Mustik, Charun, and my all brothers, myself, and so many are here, we will crush Krishna and Baldev here. He cannot be saved. So anyhow you should be. Tell them that a fire sacrifice or anything, festival is going there, and you should come, invite them. Akrur went and brought Krishna and Baldev there. And Kansa was anyhow there, was killed. When there was a big council, Krishna and Baldev came in the council. There was a big arena. Where all the
wrestlers
were wrestling together. When Krishna And Balaram came there. Krishna and Baldev were like very smooth, very sweet. A boy of only 10 years age or 9 years age.
Very soft.
Mm-hmm. And very
delicate.
Delicate, soft.
Mm-hmm. When they came, at once Charun Mustik, like Himalayan mountain, so big, big giants. Mm-hmm. They invited Krishna, oh, you should come and we will wrestle and we will please our Maharaj Kansa. Krishna and Baldev told, answered that we are very little child. So we can wrestle with any boy which are in our
equal
age, equal age, equal, equal weight.
Size.
Equal size.
In our group we can. But not Yatu, you are so
big,
like so much giants. But they told that you are not a baby.
We know.
We know that you have killed Putana, Agasur, Bagasur, always playing here, there, jumping, always wrestling to Siddham, Subal, Sakha and all others. We know all these things. So we know you. And they dragged in arena. And they began to wrestle with them. At that time, Nanda Baba was there. Also, Kansa wanted to show Devaki and Vasudev and Ugrasen Maharaj that how I am killing Krishna and Baldev, you should see. In your presence, I will kill Kansa and Krishna and Baldev. So he has invited all. He has invited all the good persons,
aristocracy
persons there, to there, to see that festival. So all were there. All the wives of Jadav, newly married or married, were there also. So they were also seeing this scene. They were telling to each other, ladies, that we should not stay here. Kansa is so bad person.
Duplicious.
He wants to kill Krishna and Baldev. That is, he has engaged Charun and Mustik and so many demons here. And if Krishna is wrestling here with Charun and Mustik, we should at once give up this place. Otherwise, sin will come to us. So anyone should not be stay there where demons wants to kill any sadhu. They have made a plan like so. And they are doing so nonsense here. So we should quit this place. Oh, we see that in Vrindavan, all the gopis are so
fortunate
that they see Krishna in his usual form,
natural form.
And here we are seeing Krishna. We are lucky somewhat to see Krishna here, but here not natural Krishna. He is now wrestling with these demons, sometimes being some anger, eyes are being reddish like, and other party
trying to kill him,
trying to smash Krishna. So we are unlucky. And they are telling to each other, Punyavata Brajabhuvo Jadayang Nilinga Guda Purana Purusha Banachitramalla Gapalayan Sahabalakarayan Shavedum Bikridyan Chatigiritra Namachitangrin. Oho. The Braj Gopi are so fortunate. In whole world, Brajmandal is so glorious. So glorious. Why? Because Supreme Personality of Godhead, taking his all opulence, with adorned with his all madhuris,
sweetness,
he had descended to Vrindavan. So Vrindavan is so glorious. Especially, the gopis are there, so Vrindavan is glorious. If gopis are not there, Vrindavan is not glorious. If gopis are not in Vrindavan with Krishna, then Krishna will be only Brahman like zero, shunya. So due to gopis, Krishna is so, so lovely. And all kinds of, four kinds of madhurya are in Krishna. So Vrindavan is so glorious. Gopis are so glorious. When Krishna begins to go in his cowherds with lakhs and lakhs girlfriends, with lakhs and lakhs cows, playing his own foot, with Baladev and so many boys, searching anywhere from his crooked eyes, and so many gopis worshipping Krishna with their
sidelong glance.
The eyes, lovely eyes. Then Krishna smiles. Those who have seen this Krishna doing so, they are lucky. And their eyes are successful. Those who have not seen Krishna, not taken darshan of this Krishna in this way, how beautiful he is. Varaha pidam natavara bapu karnayo karnikaram vibhradabhasah kanaka kapishang vejayanti chamala randhana venuradhar sudaya purayan gopa brindai brindaranyam sabadarabanam pravishatakitakirti. As if whole beauty, whole sweetness, fragrance have come in Krishna. And Krishna is like new make
clouds,
as if water will come. And his claws are like
thunderbolt, lightning,
so yellow, fragrant yellow. And he had taken float in his mouth. And he is telling something. What telling? Cling. And all are thinking that Krishna is calling me, all the gopis, deers, cows, calves, everyone thinking that Krishna is calling me. Yes. And all are attracted to Krishna. Varahapidam Natavara Bapu. He's like Natavara. What is Natavara?
Best of dancers.
Eh?
The best
transcendental dancer.
Like a drama.
Dancer. But in India, we tell
bar
to whom?
Bridegroom.
Who is going to?
Bridegroom.
Bridegroom. At that time, if a black person, young person, not so much beauty, but artificially he is made so beautiful by so much giving here
decoration.
Powders, decoration, goldly ornaments and everything. And he becomes the prominent in so many persons. So he is called Vara. The Krishna is like so beautiful now. He had not to be decorated. If he is naked, even he is so beautiful. If any spot of black is given here, even he is so beautiful. If he is naked, so more beautiful. He had not to take any help from any ornament, nothing.
For makeup.
He is naturally beautiful. And so many cowherd boys surrounding Krishna. Kanhaiya ki jai ho, Kanhaiya ki
jai. Jai Kanhaiya lal ki, Jai Kanhaiya lal ki.
They are doing like so, glorifying Krishna. And Krishna with his gentle and so soft feet, he is getting his feet on earth, making some
impression.
Shankha Chakra Gada Padma comes there. So, and gopis are here and there, looking Krishna. And they don't know that what will tell others. And nothing to give their
eyelid.
Palak nahi gire.
Their eyes
eyelid must not down.
Oh, always like this, they are looking Krishna. So beautiful Krishna there. So they are telling that these gopis are fortunate to see Krishna and to taste his beauty and all kinds of sweetness in full. But we cannot do like this. Even when Krishna supporting cows, grazing cows, with Baldev Prabhu and so many cowherd boys, playing on flute, Brahma, Shankar, Lakshmi, worship the lotus feet of Krishna. So see, he is how high. Gopyas tapakim acharan jatamushma rupam lavanya sar asmod dhananya siddham drikbhi pivant anuswan bhavan dirapam ekant dham jasasasi. Oh, these gopis, how hard astuties they have done. We want to do like same and to see Krishna in Braja. We want to have a birth in gopi womb to see and taste all these glories of Krishna. Lavanya sar asamortha ananya siddham. No need of any ornament for to increase the Krishna beauty. We sometimes take golden chain here, some iron rings here, some more other thing, but Krishna never. So he is more beautiful than Narayan, 100 times, lakh times. He is more beautiful than Ram. He is more beautiful than Dwarkadhish, because he has no flute. Now he is young, but Krishna in Vrindavan is teenage. Kishore. In Dwarka there will be no gopi, no flute, no peacock feather. Not like natural beauty of Krishna there. So they are so fortunate. What they have done, we should try to do like them. Jadohani vahanani matharopani prankhankhanarbhyudito okkhan marjanado gayant chainam anurakta dhiyo ashrukanta dhanna prajastiya rukam manjana. Jadohani vahanani matharopani. Oh, how glorious are gopis, that they are in their homes sometimes dohane, they are milking cows. But what they are doing? Their mind is not there. They are habituated to do. Automatically their hands are going and milking cow. But their heart is there, where Krishna is there. And they are singing what? Govinda Damo Dharamada Vechi Govinda Damo. Some are doing
churning.
In the morning or daytime or evening. And they are also doing like that. Their hands are accustomed to do like this. Naturally, nothing to do like this. Automatically. But their mind and tongues are going. Govinda Damo Dharamada Vechi Govinda Damo. Brahming in the house, they are also doing like this. Some are going to make sleep their children's, and they are doing like this. Oh boy, you should sleep, you should not telling, clapping like this, Govinda Dhamma Dharma. All their house jobs, everything, but always remembering. Some are cooking, and in cooking they are doing. Govinda Dhamma Dharma Dhameti, Govinda Dhamma Dharma Dhameti. All are objects so much that tears come in, automatically, hearts melting. So all are engaged. Whole day and night like this, they are making all their jobs, more than anyone, but always like this. So we can, we'll have to do, to support our children, to do our house jobs, to maintain our life. But try to make something Krishna mood there, then your all activities will be like bhakti. And if you are not doing your all pious activities also, without Krishna is like zero. If you are serving your father, mother, so much, but not chanting, remembering, you'll have to go to hell. Because our original father and mother is who? Himself, Krishna. His fathers of fathers of fathers. His sarva-karan karana. So if any man neglecting Krishna, but doing all pious activities, everything, but his all activities like zero. And if they are doing all things, brooming, clearing their houses, cooking, supporting children, and everything, but remembering Krishna, like Govinda Dhamo Dharma Dhameti, Govinda Dhamo, then your life is successful. Only money will cannot make you less successful and happy. Never. But if your all the jobs, all the activities, if it is touched with Krishna consciousness, then everything is okay. If something wrong there, it may be not complete, but even no harm, Krishna will make it full. So they are thinking that gopis are so much high class of devotees. We are not like this. We cannot see Krishna in this way. So they are doing like this. Pratah brajat brajata avishatascha sayam gobishamam kaneto asya nishamma venum nirgamya turnam apalapati bhurupanya pasyat pasyanti sasmudmikham sadayavolokam. Oh, gopis are how glorious. In the morning, when Krishna going with all cowherd boys and cows are calves, all gopis are assembled near the house of Nandabhavan. All are following Krishna. All gopis here and there, from any corner of their houses, some on the
roof.
Some are
from windows.
Windows. Some are in groups. Some are very near. Some are very far away. No harm. All are charmed. And they are looking towards Krishna and worshiping in their eyes.
Sight long.
All. And when Krishna returns from cowherd, again like this, they think that if Krishna is not there, they are feeling so much separation, as if they were dying. And when they are thinking that when morning will come, when evening will come, that when will Krishna will return with all cows, all friends, and they were all waiting there. Sometimes it becomes like so, that if any new gopis is married to Nandagaon, and she is quite new, she wants to take darshan of Krishna. But his sasuri, his mother-in-law, oh, don't go. There is a black snake there, and he will
bite
you. And that poison will never come down. And you will be met for
ever.
So don't go. But she is going herself. Her daughters are going. Then that girl, new remarried, tells that, why you are going yourself? Why your all daughters are going? Why all Brajavasi, old or new or young or even boys, all are going to see and I should not go?
No.
I must go anyhow. So he does not
listen.
Just obey.
And disobeys. And he quickly runs. And sees Krishna. Krishna also, oh, he saw that he is so eager to see me and to meet me. He had something to do, and she at once takes a tail of any
cough.
And at once he begins to run and comes to in front of that gopi. And Krishna with his foot only touches and takes her heart in his heart and quickly going. She becomes like mad, without mind, without any life, like a statue. She is only seeing that Krishna is going. After that he vanishes in forest. But there are some
dust
there. She looking towards that. Dust is also
going down.
But she is standing hours and hours. Then her
mother-in-law
comes and says, why are you standing here? Oh, come on with me. I told you that a black snake will bite you, and he has surely bite you. Come on. And he gives any job to her. Or to?
Churning yogurt.
Churning. Anything he gives. But his mind is not there. So she brought a pot full of
mustard seed.
And she began. She thought that it is curd. So, in prison, all are made for Krishna like this. So, if you are not going to meet like this, but anyhow you should chant and remember. So, one day you can serve Krishna. So, gopis are so glorious. Now our time is 7. Perhaps our Brahma is
ready.
Also ready. You should make ready. Gaur Brahma. Today, no?
No, they're using it in the
drama.
Achha.
So, you should do it. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol.
Achha. You know?
Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana
Hari Bol. He was worried, and then Lord asked him to do meditation, tapa. And then Lord himself revealed himself before Lord Brahma, and gave him the knowledge of Vedic knowledge. He spoke Srimad Bhagavatam in 4 verses. Then how come Lord Brahma couldn't recognize Lord Krishna? Because he was already given the knowledge.
Because yoga maya of Krishna is so powerful that even Baldev, who is Krishna himself, sometimes he forgets everything. So it is not a strange for yoga maya to make Brahma like this. Huh?
What announcement?
Pustak Bengali.
All the devotees who are leaving tomorrow morning, tomorrow afternoon, maybe even this evening, if you have any place in your car going to San Francisco,
condition. An ecstatic mood manifested in his body, face in Subhadra, and she could not go to of the mellow of Vajra. Meanwhile, Vajra gradually becoming worse, life in the body of Radharani around her. They could not understand what to do. Radharani was giving up her body.
Hare 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 Jai 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 Shri Hare.
Devotees of Vrindavan or in India, very rare, very rare. So you are fortunate to realize this mode and to play. I think that you are making ready this for some long time. Actually, you are all successful. My heartly blessings to you. Try to develop this more eternal to Krishna. This is a very high class of devotees in the line of devotees like Rupanjari. I am praying to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I pray to Nityananda Prabhu to sprinkle their mercy, for which they have descended to me. And now I am seeing that very far away from Vrindavan, lakhs and lakhs miles opposite in this world from Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, that is Vrindavan, and opposite the other world, there is perhaps morning four or five, and here is now like this. But even there is no culture like Indian culture, but by the grace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates, this very rare and highest mode of Vrindavan Braj now descended in a new Braj. I think the mission of Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Bhakti Vinod Thakur and the mission of Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj and my guru is now successful. That even rare, but you are one of the rares, the devotees and praja. So try to keep these things forever in your life and eternal in that life. Don't deviate from this life. I'm praying also Radha Krishna conjugal. Jog Maya. Uddhav, Narada also. That they should sprinkle their mercy. Without their help, without their mercy, anyone cannot have this rare mood. This mood also Narada wants, but he has not that said. Whether he has become dust or not dust in Vrindavan, Uddhav, Narada also, we don't know. Anywhere in Shastri is not written. But you are so fortunate to have this rare mood in you. So try to keep it here safe, very safe, and so that gradually it will come develop. So my heartly blessings to you. Also, my mission is also successful, that we are inspired to play a drama like this. I think in world, anywhere, we will not find a drama like this. Very beautiful. want to request all the devotees of New Braja that they should live brotherhoodly, that we are all in Gaur family, and try to develop all these things. You will never see in anywhere in, you will go to India, in Haridwar, in South India, you will go to Kashi, you will not find all these things. Anywhere in world, this world. So I want that. These things to be protected and try to develop. I want that they should all be together, and they should, in 1 week or 2 weeks, they should assemble anywhere, discuss all these things as a broad brotherhood. Like we are brother and sister, and thus we should try to develop all these things. And I think very soon, Krishna will be merciful, Mahaprabhu will be merciful to take you all in prayer. So I request all that they should, I also want that there should be a school here, so that children may be educated in this line. So I am requesting and praying you all that you should assemble, make a samiti, means society, and go on doing this. This is the best way to follow or to develop or to fulfill the inner desire of your Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Mahaprabhu and Abha. And by doing this, you will be very so happy. I want that there should be no friction. Have tolerance and try to each other helping in Krishna consciousness. I am so much indebted to these girls. Being the girls, teeny age or little boys, and how they knew this mood of Braja. Very rare. So you should keep this mood in your heart and try to develop Krishna consciousness. Gaur Prema. Anything?
I have one thing. If someone knows where the keys to the generator.
Radhe 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 Rad Thank you. small one. Which small riding car or big riding car?
Both men.
Both
daughters.
Ragalata. Gurudev, they wanted me to tell you. Monday is more?
Yes.
Other one, Grandma.
Gurudev, the girls wanted me to tell you that the script for the drama came from Gorgovinda Maharaj, the beggar of Prem.
I think it's good that I have it.
This is the other guy.
This is good. This is Giriraj. Twins. Govardhan.
Yes.
And she's sleeping. I bless you.
Sorry. Happy but somewhat sad. We're leaving tomorrow.
Naramadeti Govindamo Naramadeti. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe.
Come and see you in the morning. We leave around 8:00, 8:30.
You are all so successful. All successful.
We have one preliminary cover now of Jiva Dharma to show you. I don't know, maybe in the morning we can show
you. You can show just now.
Or now if you like.
It is ready?
Yeah.
Okay, just now. Yeah. After that, I'll show you. What's your name, please?
Nayana Mani Manjari.
And your name, please?
Yes, Nayana Mani Manjari.
This is her name. I'm Prashangi.
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 Very good.
Prashangi. That's her name.
Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta's name was mentioned.
Yes, I hear that. Yes.
What is your name?
What? My name is Lalit Mohan Lal. Lalit Mohan
Lal. What is your seva?
Marasiva.
Joking.
I'm not leaving.
Jai 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 Shri Radhe.
Sanskrit.
Very secret. Very secret. So that it should not go out of the world. Yes, so try to make it transcendent. And Adarsh Bhakti Mane Kyare?
Ideal devotee.
Ideal. Whether ladies or
gents.
No harm. But you see. Make this place like, certainly like Braja. If you are like that, I will be so happy.
Jai.
Jai Jai Sri.
Jai
Sri.
Jai.
More loudly. Jai Jai
Sri.
Are searching you.
Never.
Hi, Srila Gurudev ki.
That's you.
You liked your pictures? They were
yeah.
In Houston?
Yeah.
I like the
Giriraj Govardhan Ki Jai. This is Giriraj Das Jones. Maharaj said, I have a new dynasty. And here is the fruit.
You definitely do have a dynasty.
The dynasty. The Mahibar dynasty.
And now they're all blessed by the pure devotees.
They were in
Nothing to say. No comment at this point. Nothing to say. Rusty, if you really want to get a mugshot here, you want to get the most advanced person.
No.
In the Badger area, in the Bay Area. Rasi Mohan Maharaj.
The most advanced person in England.
In the Western
area,
in the
West
Bengal.
Lotus feet. Get a look at those. Touch them, guys. Touch those feet. Come on. Oh, yeah.
Jai, Jai. He's a brownie, you know. Oh, Jai.
Gurudev's would-be secretary when he comes of age. Oh, forgive my offenses, Maharaj. Forgive me.
You know how you'll forgive me?
Come on, Mark.
The only one thing that makes it uncomfortable.
Hello. Too late.
Yeah.
Take it to Grandpa.
Here, I got you. Oh, yeah. We got it.